in, and it's a huge pleasure to be here. This is the first truly live thing I've done since lockdown. It's very exciting. So it was such a pleasure to find out on Sunday that I would be playing here for you this afternoon. It's nice to see some familiar faces as well. Excellent, indeed. So that was not really jazz, but it was popular in its day, of course, the Knightsbridge March by Eric Coates from the London Suite, written in 1933. And it was extremely popular because it was used for the BBC Radio chat show In Town Tonight. So I thought that was a nice stirring one to start with. Do you know, I feel terribly posh here today because on a Thursday evening, I'm the accompanist for the Leatherhead Choral Society, as some of you here would probably recognise. I'm not allowed to have the lid open on a Thursday night because I'm too late. So don't tell Ian. Something a little bit quieter now, it was subdued, and it's by one of my favourite composers, Astor, Piazzolla, who was an Argentinian bandoneonist, arranger, composer. And he was responsible for rebuilding the art of the tango and wrote over 600 tangos during his lifetime. And this is one of his more sedate ones, one of his later ones from the early 1980s. And it's got a rather bleak title of Oblivion. Don't know that for you. It is a very beautiful and haunting melody. And when I've played it before, it's been known to make people burst into tears. I'm not quite sure why, but it's produced the way I play it. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
That's all the right stuff. So now moving on to, again, one of my favourite composers, Michel Legrand. And Michel Legrand passed away in 2019, and I had the great pleasure of watching him live on six occasions and being absolutely mesmerised by his amazing skill as a composer. So what I'm going to play for you now is my version of his suite from the film Les Parapluies de Cherbourg, quite appropriate for the weather today, I think, written in 1964, which was a pretty seminal film. It has no dialogue in that film, everything is sung through recitative and song. And so what I've done is cut down his orchestral suite, which was about 24 minutes, and it'll be about 10 or 11, depending on what happens. So I hope you enjoy the suite from Les Parapluies de Cherbourg. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gershwin's Rhapsody in Oblivion, which means no introduction, which is why I'm giving it one, written in 1924, and originally written for solo piano and jazz band, with Paul Whiteman's jazz band giving its premiere with a composer of piano. Interesting fact I only found out late last night was that Billy Mayerl gave the London premiere of Rhapsody in Oblivion in 1925. Well, I never, I can see ahead again. Well, I never. I know, it used to be as well. Anyway, it's appeared in many guises over the years. And this is the solo piano version, which was done by the composer. Actually, I should say, it's a version of the solo piano version, which covers itself, doesn't it, that anything might happen along the way.
Thank you.
different every time, that way. So, I think we're just going to give you one more to send you on your way, if that's okay, Mr. Controller. Yeah, wonderful. And I think we'll leave the last word to Gershwin. And my particular version of his song, I Got Rhythm. Well, I say it's mine, actually, most of it is his, really. It's the thing I do is take bits of various arrangements he did during his lifetime and add a little bit more. And I think this is a nice, cheery way to send you on your way. You're absolutely lovely, you're all smiling and happy, and it's so nice to be truly live again. So enjoy.